إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله. عباد الله، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله تعالى. قال الله عز وجل: يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. Or those who believe. Indeed, the fasting has been prescribed for you in order for you to attain piety. And that is in regards to the fasting in Ramadan. The ulama says, indeed, we leave the year, we enter the new year, preparing ourselves for Ramadan. When Ramadan comes in, we prepare ourselves for the last 10 days of Ramadan. When the last 10 days of Ramadan comes, we prepare ourselves for the Laylatul Qadr, for the night of power, for the night of decree. For verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed a surah as a whole in regard to the night that we are seeking. For wallahi, what really brings emotion is the fact that we have started Ramadan and the half of Ramadan is gone. We have already entered the last third part of Ramadan and many of us are still seeking the sweetness of fasting and the sweetness of standing in front of Allah Azza wa Jal. And many of us are still thinking, have Allah Azza wa Jal forgiven our sin? And many of us are still taking Ramadan as a kind of normal month, but don't even have the feeling that once these 9 days that are left will be gone, there might not be no chance again that we're going to come back in this state. Indeed, for those people, for the 1,443 years after Hijrah, this year Allah Azza wa Jalla has chosen you from the Ummah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to spend Ramadan. Wallahi, it's because Allah is Al-Wadud. Because Allah is the most loving. And because He loves you. And He wants you to have these kind of nights and days in order for this to be your key of Jannah. You can never know that your key of Jannah could be found in the last 10 days and nights of Ramadan. For therefore, blessed are those who are still living and breathing the Ramadan of the year 1443, or 2022, you want to call it. My brothers and sisters on the other side, when you sit and think about the blessing we are in, if the people of the grave were to talk and they would say, we wish we would come up and spend the day of Ramadan and go back in the grave. This is what the ulama says. Because knowing of the merits and the reward of Ramadan in itself, now we are going into the last 10 days. We've already gone into the last 10 days of Ramadan. Today is the 21st day of Ramadan in the UAE. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when it comes to these days, focusing in the night, standing in front of Allah Azza wa Jal in the night, because the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَمَنْ قَامَ لَيْلَةَ الْقَدْرِ إِيمَانًا وَاحْتِسَابًا غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِهِ. And whoever stand in front of Allah Azza wa Jal on the night of Laylatul Qadr, indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive all his previous sins. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he would stay in the masjid for the last 10 days and night of Ramadan, seeking Laylatul Qadr. The one who sins, mistake, promise of Jannah, mistake all been forgiven. And he was exerting himself in worship of Allah Azza wa Jal in the last 10 nights of Ramadan. Where are we? Where are we? And are we more deserving of the rahmah of Allah Azza wa Jal? We don't even know our fate. We may wake up in the morning as mu'min and go to bed as a non-believer. We may wake up in the morning as an obedient slave of Allah and we go to bed in the night as a disobedient slave of Allah Azza wa Jal. What guarantee do we have? If the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to pray until his feet used to be sodden, where are we? When these last 10 nights come in place, we need to think, if he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to exert himself where he didn't have to, it's an example for us to follow. Indeed, we cannot do as much as he did, but we can do as much as we can to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he would wake up his family. The elders and the young and the women will all be praying in the night of the last 10 nights of Ramadan. For Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if ever you are to taharra, you're going to look for the Laylatul Qadr, look for that night in the last 10 nights of Ramadan. In another report, in the last odd number nights of Ramadan, 21st, 23rd, 25th, 27th, 29th. On the safer side, for the last 10 nights of Ramadan, we exert ourselves to seek Laylatul Qadr. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ. And what will make you know and understand what is Laylatul Qadr? The best night in the eyes of Allah Azza wa Jal. The night which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descend the Quran from Lawh al-Mahfuz to Baytul Izzah. The first revelation, Ramadan. Laylatul Qadr. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Laylatul Qadr khayrun min alf shahr. The ibadah that you do in this night, the way you please Allah, the sujood, the ruku', the du'a, the qira'ah of the Quran, each and every word of what you read, the sadaqah, every kind of good deed that you do in this night, it is not only equivalent to 1,000 months, indeed it is better than doing them more than 1,000 months. This is how equivalent it is. More than 1,000 months, if you make one sajda to Allah Azza wa Jalla, that is the ajr of what you get. In that night, losers are those who sleep through these nights. Losers are those who don't even care about this night. Where is their Ramadan if they're not seeking Laylatul Qadr, which is the pearl and the pinnacle of Ramadan? تَنَزَّلُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ وَالْرُوحُ فِيهَا بِإِذْنِ رَبِّهِمْ مِنْ كُلِّ أَمْرٍ. In this night, تَنَزَّلُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes down in the last heaven. Allah Azza wa Jal bring down all the angels in the dunya alongside Jibreel alayhi salatu wa salam. Jibreel alayhi salatu wa salam, his time of revelation, that was his job. But for the Laylatul Qadr, Jibreel alayhi salatu wa salam come in the dunya. And what the purpose of the malaika in the dunya, Laylatul Qadr, what do? They send peace and blessing and forgiveness, and they say ameen to your dua. They say ameen to your dua of what you say in your sujood, in Qiyam al-Layl, in your tahajjud. This will happen in this night, and it does not happen except one night of the year. And it varies. We do not know exactly when it is, but until the last 10 nights of Ramadan. Salamun hiya hatta matla'il fajr. Tranquility, peace, and blessing until the dawn pops up. The night of Laylatul Qadr is something that we are seeking in the last 10 nights of Ramadan. Started yesterday. And we will be going, inshallah, by the wisdom of Allah, until we see the moon of Shawwal. We are going to seek Laylatul Qadr, wherever you are, in any masajid you are. Make the most of it in order for you to be forgiven and gain the pearls of Ramadan. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, ati'u Allah wa ati'u Rasul, wa ulil amri minkum. Nafa'ani Allahu iyaikum bil Qur'an al-Azim. وبسنة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. عائشة رضي الله عنها asked the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, يا رسول الله, if ever we are exerting ourselves in ibadah, or we come to know what night it is, what shall we do and what shall we say? The specific dua that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught Aisha to say, say, Allahumma, innaka afuun tuhibbul afwa, fa'afu anni. Allahumma, O Allah, innaka, anta tuhibbul afwa. Indeed, Ya Allah, you love to forgive. فَعْفُ عَنِّي. So forgive me, Ya Allah. It's all about forgiveness. It's all about Allah is opening the door of forgiveness. You want to leave the door of the masjid every night. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made you as a newborn baby in regards to your bad deeds record. This is the main aim of Laylatul Qadr, in order for your sin to be erased. A question may arise for the sisters who are on their menses. What do they do? The men are going to pray. The ladies, if ever they want to exert themselves in ibadah, in Laylatul Qadr, they may read the Quran, they may make their dua, they may make their adhkar. The thing that they stay away from is only the salah. They also can get the reward of Laylatul Qadr, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easy upon us all, in order for us to gain the reward of Laylatul Qadr. هذا وصلوا وسلموا على من أمرتم بالصلاة والسلام عليه. قال الله تعالى إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وآل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وذل الشرك والمشركين.